When a narcissist realizes they're losing control over you, this is what happens. Today's video addresses a plethora of questions that all circle back to this main topic. Narcissists have certain defining characteristics in common, and we will explore what happens when their plans go awry, what common reactions and behaviors they exhibit, and what they do when they are in your sights after being exposed. Furthermore, if a narcissist loses control over an individual, what happens? Everyone, if you found this video helpful or informative, I would be very grateful if you would consider subscribing to my channel. Please note that this video is not intended to diagnose or treat mental health issues, and professional help should always be sought in addition to viewing this video. Firstly, narcissism is characterized by a person's inability to see things from another person's perspective, their inability to tolerate criticism, and their sense of superiority and entitlement. Consequently, they frequently exhibit ruthless and deceptive behaviors, and they have a limited ability to empathize with others. Of course, we have all been guilty of such behavior on occasion. However, the hallmarks of pathological narcissism are marked by their incessant and extensive display. They remain unchanged regularly. Given how vindictive they can be, it is only natural to worry about what happens when their secrets are revealed. We cannot always anticipate how they will act. If you weren't dating a narcissist or grew up in a narcissistic family, you may have an idea of how they will react when they realize they no longer have control over you. To understand this, you must first know that narcissists often judge their own value based on how much attention they receive from others. This narrow worldview leads them to think poorly of themselves. If they do not receive the attention and validation they need voluntarily or to their unrealistically high standards, they resort to bullying, shaming, and other forms of manipulation. Secondly, narcissists often engage in shameful behavior to alleviate their feelings of envy and shame. They may disregard the values of others, reject them, punish them, cheat on them, or scorn them, for example. These activities can drive people away. When narcissists lose control of someone, they usually react in a few typical ways. First and foremost, they may apologize. Narcissists may express their remorse directly to you. However, they may not regret their actions or care about the harm they have caused. The vast majority of individuals who have harmed others feel remorseful for their actions. They feel bad about being abandoned and revealing their true selves. However, narcissists are not typical in this regard. Another common justification is, "It's not me, I'm just anxious." They may argue that they are powerless in this situation due to their illness. They may claim that they are not to blame for being in this predicament due to their addiction, and so on. It's also possible for them to qualify their apology with a statement like, "I'm sorry, you did say something 10 years ago that I found quite upsetting." Even if you receive a genuine apology, it's unlikely to last more than a minute, a day, or a week when dealing with narcissists. They have a tendency to revert to their previous ways of doing things and only discover a temporary solution to a common issue. It's also possible that they're not truly sorry, but rather trying to reason with you. Just imagine the narcissist's reaction, where they only answer queries with a single word or no communication at all. They might send you a text message or email with the words, "I don't know what I did to hurt you, but I'll always love you," followed by a string of incoherent statements that amount to a disguised threat. "And I'm going to let other people know what you're like. However, I want you to know that I will always care deeply about you." On the other hand, if you do get such a message, or if you're thinking about giving them another chance after an apology, pleading, or tears, "I won't talk you out of it, but I will ask you to consider your past experiences. How many apologies have you received before? There probably weren't very many of them, but how few were there? So did the bad actions end when the apologies were made? If it didn't change previously, why should you expect it to now?" Narcissists tend to ignore reality and act as if it never happened when they're exposed as liars. They will never admit to you or anyone else that they're being toxic. If they can't even admit to themselves that they're wrong, made a mistake, or have limitations, then they'll likely make baseless accusations. They'll make something else out of what you've said or done, and make up excuses for their previous words and deeds. They might also purposely misinterpret you and your intentions, emphasizing the word deliberately. If you've been with the same type of person for a while, they've had plenty of opportunities to polish their talents as manipulators and gaslighters. If it seems like other people believe their story, you may start to doubt your own sanity. People with covert narcissism are skilled at concealing their violent nature behind a facade of humility and regret. Thirdly, following a breakup, the narcissist may attempt to contact your friends, family, and colleagues, often under the guise of being concerned about your well-being. They might say things like, "I haven't heard from them in a while. I hope everything's all right." They may even take an interest in your hobbies or social groups, infiltrating your circle of friends and making personal connections with your loved ones. The purpose of this is to recruit flying monkeys, or trusted individuals who can act as the narcissist's spies and provide them with information about your life. It is also an attempt to control how the narcissist's victim is perceived by others, as narcissism is inherently destructive and seeks to tear things apart from the inside out. Fourthly, the narcissist will use emotional manipulation to make the victim take responsibility for the narcissist's misdeeds. After any kind of breakup, whether platonic or romantic, the narcissist will go to great lengths to elicit sympathy and pity from their victim. They may cry, plead, become angry, and continue to appeal to the victim until they admit that they were at fault. In other words, the narcissist will blame the victim for their own misdeeds, even though they were the ones who caused the problem in the first place. Fifthly, narcissists act in a hostile and vindictive manner. In the narcissist's view, it is incredibly arrogant of you to see through their deception. It is frustrating for them when they realize that you will not tolerate their nonsense. It is important to remember that narcissists have an inflated sense of self-worth, which they use to justify their negative behavior towards you. When provoked, some people may act violently or destructively, and this is especially true for narcissists. They may spread harmful rumors to tarnish your reputation or withhold resources intentionally. In short, they will do whatever they think will give them an advantage over their victims. It is as if they feel obligated to teach their victims a valuable lesson. Sixth, if they have no other means of influence, they will try to create a trauma bond through trickery, manipulation, and threats. The victim may come to accept the narcissist's harmful behavior, which is typical for the narcissist, but not for anyone else. To an outsider looking in, the abused person may appear to be dependent on the narcissist for psychological or emotional support. Perhaps the victim is completely reliant on the narcissist for financial support, which the narcissist may exploit. There is a strong correlation between abuse and dependency, which may make it difficult for the victim to leave an abusive relationship. This could be due to a physical issue, such as a health concern or a trust issue, where the victim no longer trusts anyone, not even themselves. Narcissists will create a powerful attachment called a trauma bond to prevent their victims from leaving them. If it already exists, they will do everything in their power to strengthen it, making it almost impossible for the victim to establish autonomy or break free. In general, the aforementioned characteristics and behaviors are commonly exhibited by a narcissist who feels they are losing control over another person. Of course, I have only scratched the surface of this topic. There are many fascinating discussions taking place in response to these videos. If you have anything to add to the conversation, please share it in the comments section below. If you found this video helpful, I would greatly appreciate it if you considered subscribing to my channel. Thank you for watching.
So, let's summarize today's video. As you all know already, narcissists are masters of deception and often lead a double life, making it difficult to identify them. So it's essential to understand that not everyone who exhibits narcissistic traits has narcissistic personality disorder. Narcissists emotionally exploit and manipulate others, subjecting them to gaslighting, guilt trips, or even physical or mental abuse in their efforts to maintain power and control. It's crucial to establish limits to prevent them from bullying or manipulating you. Here are some methods that have been proven to be effective when dealing with a narcissist. 1. Never give them attention. Narcissists crave attention very much, and if you give them any attention, they will latch onto it. Act as though their actions that bother you are not a big problem. Do not fall for their passive-aggressive actions or tricks, even if they are trying to hurt you on purpose. When a narcissist realizes they have no control over you, they will feel humiliated. The method number 2, you should avoid your ego. It's crucial to understand that being right or having the last word is not always necessary for success. Instead, focus on taking care of yourself and avoiding behaviors that may be perceived as desperate or pleading. By prioritizing your own well-being and letting go of the need to always be right, you can protect yourself from the negative effects of interacting with a narcissist. Number 3. Setting strong boundaries, they will prevent narcissists. One effective way to manage interaction with narcissists is to set clear boundaries and communicate them assertively. Remember that narcissists may feel entitled to more than they deserve and may not respond well to a simple no. And method number 4, collect all the proof that you can. In interactions with narcissists, it's essential to keep detailed records of all communication, whether written in a paper or electronic. Having accurate and comprehensive documentation can also provide a sense of security and confidence when dealing with narcissists. All in all, dealing with narcissists can be challenging, but it's possible to communicate with them safely without risking your well-being. Remember to never give them attention, avoid ego, set strong boundaries, and collect all the proof you can. By prioritizing your own well-being, you can protect yourself from the negative effects of interacting with a narcissist. This is everything I can say in today's video. Please share your thoughts and experiences about this topic in the comment section below. And your presence here is greatly appreciated. And thank you for watching this video.